us a man in that season. Just getting homes ready. And I know we need to be getting this home ready.
Right.
Coming of the Lord. So here we are, we're doing worship and praise, and I'm still, thank God I got a great partner. I'm sitting there scribbling still for today. And so basically, you changed the message. So anyway, it's like, okay, Lord, let me look at the scripture here where you want us to go today. But we're going to start off, we got some wonderful children here today. And I got, see, I don't know if I brought it up with me or not, let me look, I didn't. Bring it up, there's something, it was so precious to me, it was something Pastor gave me. And he said, well, Vina, if you want that, you can have that. And I just love children and Jesus, because I'm still a kid. I'm still a child, and I need a daddy.
Amen.
I need him right now, because he just changed the message. But this little thing with Jesus and the Good Shepherd, there was a part in our song that said he'll leave the 99 and go after the one. Now the staff, this isn't the message, it's just prelude, but this staff is a little crusty. And I thought about cleaning it up, but really, how many times has the Good Shepherd got to draw us out of muddy waters?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
And I believe that staff is a little muddy even today, still drawing people out of muddy waters.
Thank you, Lord.
And he has such a good, he'll leave the 99. He don't have nothing to do with self-righteous, because it says, well, if you're not sick, you're not, you know, you don't even believe you're a sinner and never sinned or anything, well, I can't really deal with you because you're living in deception. But he says, that one that's fallen, that one that's crying out to me, that one that was in my fold, that one that I want back in my fold, and not necessarily that they're out of salvation if they die today, but just out of his blessings, and they can't receive the grace for whatever reason, because he got back in deception, because sin is, as we all know, is very deceptive, and it could come on any of us. But these little children, they're just dancing. And I thought about that song, Dancing in the Fire. They're just dancing.
Amen.
They're just enjoying Jesus.
Amen.
They don't have a care in the world. They're not worrying about what they're going to eat, this, that, or whatever. They're just fellowshipping
with
Jesus. And that's what he wants us to do today. Sin really shouldn't be a problem. He already taken care of it at the cross.
Amen.
You know, we wrestle with it. He already wrestled with it several years ago. He wrestled for us, put it upon his back. So we didn't have to wrestle with it. Sometimes we wrestle with it too long. And he takes a while to get our attention. He says, now can I have that? Can I have that so you can be like this? Dancing, fellowshipping with Jesus, and being able, we sing that song, I love that song about coming to the table. It's like, just come to the table.
Amen.
Get to the altar and come to the table so you can enjoy sweet fellowship with me. So he is still the Good Shepherd because of his goodness and mercy. It says it's because of the goodness and kindness of God that even leads us to repentance. And praise God. And that message will be true today until we take our last breath. There isn't anyone that doesn't need to repent at times. I'm not there yet. If not, I've always said he would have taken me home already because the finished work is done in me. But the finished work of Christ is done in me, thank God, because of his righteousness. But we're just to be like those little lambs, trusting in him. And sometimes, I don't know about you, we got to be carried in life. When life gets hard, don't think I've just got to make it, I've got to do it. Let him just carry you for a season. And when he's carrying you, you get so near his presence, you get to know him better. That's really what he wants, just to know him better.
Yes.
He just, because he says his ways are our ways, our thoughts aren't necessarily his thoughts, even though we have the mind, we do have the mind of Christ. If you know him today, if you've received him as your Savior, we have the mind of Christ, but we still have to be completely transformed by renewing of our mind. So just be like these little children today and just receive what God's got for you. He's not out to beat you. He's not out to condemn you. He did not come to condemn the world, but he came to save the world.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the little feet, Most of the little feet were broken. And there's a scripture, I can't repeat it verbatim, I'll be honest, but where he had to wash Peter, and he says, you're clean through the word. Mm-hmm. He says, well, I don't have to wash you over every time, just your feet. And sometimes their feet get astray, and they go off on the wrong path. Mm-hmm. And then he's got to direct us and lead us back on the right path.
Amen.
And it's not that you got to get saved all over. I don't know about you, but I used to go to the altar quite a bit, because I just didn't have the assurance of salvation. I just had to go up there and get saved every time. So I didn't trust in the finishing work. I had to know that greater in my life. So, he's such a wonderful Savior, healer.
Amen.
He really is. And look, this one's just reaching out for him. That's all we got to do when we get in trouble.
Yeah.
He'll never get away. He'll do this.
Yeah.
How can I help you? My hands are extended towards you. So we're going to start off though with the songs today. These children have been practicing very hard, so we're not going to go back and practice and all that, but I want them to come up forward.
Amen.
Come on up forward. Okay, remember the one? Because you said, Lord, to work out our salvation, Father. So, Lord, may these words be edified. Lord, they may even be correcting. But, Father, Lord, whatever you need to do, you do it. We're just here to receive. And, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the word that we can hear. So open up our ears to hear, Lord. Give us ears to hear today. And, Lord, once again, wash us. If we got anything to keep us from fellowship from you through that cleansing blood of Jesus, Lord. We just ask forgiveness, Father. If we've done anything to keep separation from you, or we're just not quite as close as we were. And I ask this, Lord, in the precious and the mighty name of Jesus, our Savior and our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. I'm going to read out if anybody wants to turn into Daniel. And Daniel is one because of you. He just, my son-in-law's name, Daniel. And I'm going to Daniel 3. And I'm just going to start reading. Nebuchadnezzar, the king, made an image of gold whose height was 80 cubits and the breadth thereof 6 cubits. And he set it up in the plain of Dur in the province of Babylon. Then Nebuchadnezzar, the king, sent to gather together the princes, the governors, the captains, the judges, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, and all the rulers of the provinces to come to the dedication of the image which Nebuchadnezzar, the king, had set up. So basically, he was making an image of himself. Then the princes, the governors, the captains, the judges, the treasurers, the counselors, the sheriffs, I'm in verse 3 right now, and all the rulers of the provinces were gathered together unto the dedication of the image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. And they stood before the image that Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Then a herald cried aloud, "To you it is commanded, O people, nations, and languages, that at what time you hear the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, the sackbut, the psaltery, the dulcimer, and all kinds of music, you will fall down and worship the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king has set up. And whoso falls not down and worship, not just bow down, but worship, shall at the same hour be cast into the midst of a burning, fiery furnace. Therefore, at the time when all the people heard the sound of the cornet, the flute, the harp, the sackbut, the psaltery, and all kinds of music, all the people, the nations, and the languages fell down and worshipped the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Wherefore, at that time, certain Chaldeans came near and accused the Jews." Now, at this point, the Jews were in captivity, and they were brought into a foreign land. And be honest, we're in a foreign land today. Because this world, we don't live in this world. This world is a foreign world. This is not our home. If you know Jesus Christ, this isn't the place we're going to live and die, and that's it. One day we're expecting Jesus to come back for us and truly send us home. So we're not to be so ingrained in this world and everything in this world that we can't not leave this world at the time. We got a picture back where Lot and his wife, she couldn't leave the world that she was at. She turned into a pillar of salt. We'll get into that today, but she turned because she looked back. What was precious was more to her, that country, everything that she lived in, she could not leave that. And yet God was wanting to send her in a better place, and he's wanting to even send us to a better place even here today. But we have to know that this world is not our home. It says, be not conformed to the world.
Amen.
And we got more and more governmental laws that are trying to get us to conform to the world that aren't matching up to God's laws.
Yes.
But he says, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. By the renewing of your mind. Because if your thoughts go toward what the world tells you what to think, what to do, and this and that, I'm telling you, you will be in danger. You will be in danger. Our nation right now, and I call it still by faith a Christian nation, but many of the laws are not that have been set up in the land. Now, here was a law set up, a commandment for them to follow, and they were to worship Nebuchadnezzar. Well, we got these Jews, and we are grafted into the Jews. We're one tree by faith. We thank you, Lord, for the Jewish heritage, because we were grafted in. They were grafted out, but many have come to know Jesus Christ. Praise God on that. Praise God.
Amen.
And so anyway, we're one tree. Jews, Gentiles, that's all they called them back then. We didn't have Presbyterians, Methodists, and all this other separation stuff. It was just Jews and and Gentiles. And the Jews were the people of God. Now today, because of Jesus dying on the cross, he took that separation. Just whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. We can call upon his name, ask forgiveness of our sins, and we can receive what the Jews did back then, that refused, but we can receive from him forgiveness of sins. So we can be the people of God. Now back then in the Old Testament, the people of God were set apart. They were set apart to do differently. We are set apart today to do differently. We are not to act like the world, talk like the world, walk like the world. If you do, you're going the wrong direction. Because it says, be not conformed to the world in Romans 12:1. So here's this commandment. They got a predicament here. They're going to have to decide who to obey. Now, if they don't obey this commandment, like the song says, it may not be looking good for them. They may be after going through some fire.
That's right.
So that's why it says we're to encourage one another and all the more as you see that day approaching. Because we are to encourage one another to stay strong and be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
Amen.
So that's why we gather together. I know a lot of things I don't need to be in church, well, this and that, but there is a day coming. If you are alone, you may fall. You may fall short. And usually people that fall short that's been in churches or some assembly or whatever that once was, a lot of them come back. Because they realize they need the body. How do we know we're a body? We need one another. I need you. You need me. We Amen. All have each right. a part to present to the body.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but even if my body may be partly ugly, say I had cancer and this and that, my first reaction ain't just going to cut it off. Amen. I kind of want to say more. I kind of like more. And that's how we're to treat one another. Don't cut somebody off because it's like, well, I can't believe that happened to them. Don't want to walk with them no more. Don't want to be around them. No, we're to restore them. We're to restore them.
Amen.
They're my body. We're to love our body.
Amen.
Now, here they got this predicament. So here they are. They're in a foreign country. They literally were led into Babylon. They even changed their